I'm Gill Wright. I'm a physician and I'm with Metro Health Department.
Hi, I'm Fred Smith, Nashville Fire Department, Assistant Chief of EMS Operations.
We'll be talking today about how to don and doff cloth masks and how to store them and how to clean them as appropriate.
The first thing we need to talk about is how do we store our masks or our face coverings that we're going to be using. There's several different examples here on the desk. First of all, and most people have access to this right away, is just a basic Ziploc bag. Now this is convenient and a larger one works better. That way you're not fussing with the bag and having to get tangled up with it to put your mask inside or retrieve it. But another great idea is a sandwich meat container. Once you get your sandwich out and you've thrown away the product, clean the container very well, and your mask fits nicely inside of the container. Or from your visit at the restaurant, your styrofoam container works very well. Put your name right on the outside of it. And there's just different types of containers that you can use that are convenient for you. It keeps your mask a little safer and a little cleaner and away from other people. When you wash your mask, return it. You can either throw away the container if it's convenient for you to do so, or wash it at the same time. The recommended use of washing practice for the mask is to wash it with Dawn dishwashing liquid or whatever liquid you have in your sink. Wash it thoroughly, wash your hands thoroughly, and then hang it to dry. It's not necessarily recommended we put this in the washing machine and dryer. It doesn't necessarily hold up so well, but this is a good mask. It offers a great deal of protection to the wearer, and washing it with soap and water and hanging it to dry is the best practice.
Okay, so we're going to talk today about donning and doffing masks, or putting them on and off in simpler terms. So the first thing that's always important is that we go ahead and really clean our hands well. In this case, I've got some hand sanitizer I'm going to use. I'm going to make sure I clean my hands really well. I'm going to make sure I get between all the knuckles and all of that, fingernails, make sure that I get it good and dry then. And then I'm going to open my container, and as I open my container, I'm going to reach in and I'm going to grab just the loops for that. And as I pull it out, I'm going to make sure that I've got the top where I want it, and then I'm going to put it under my chin and reach up and put the loops over my ears. Now, if I need to adjust it a little bit, I can reach with my fingers and just adjust the top or the bottom, but don't reach inside the mask to do that. Once the mask is on, please don't keep touching the mask, because every time you touch it, you're potentially picking up virus. So, and then when you're done getting it on, you're gonna wanna wash your hands good again, because it has potentially been contaminated. So wash your hands or hand sanitizer. To take it off, it's just the opposite. So you start out, wash your hands good, use your hand sanitizer, get that done. Then you reach up and grab the loops and lift them off your ears and just pull it off. And then very carefully just set it in your container, dropping the loops in at the last. Go ahead and close your container up. And then again, get your hand sanitizer out and wash your hands. Thought it might also be important to talk a little bit about masks that have got ties on them or that are pleated in the front. If you're wearing the pleats go down. Again, you want to, when you pick it up out of the container, you want to grab the ties. And the first thing you're going to want to do is put the first one on top and tie up above your ears. Once that's on, then you're going to want to grab the bottoms and may pull down. Again, tie back here, and then again, if you need to adjust, pull it down on the outside, and then wash your hands and stuff. On taking this type off, again, the same thing applies. Wash your hands good, go back to your ties and undo them. Now it's a little more as you're taking it off, you're gonna wanna hang on to both sets of ties so that they don't flop down and contaminate something else. You're going to want to set your mask in the container and then lay your ties in there with it. And then go ahead and close your container up, and then good hand washing afterwards.
So I really want to emphasize proper hand washing. That's the critical component to putting on the masks and taking the masks off. Remember, always wash your hands before you touch the mask, before you put it on, and as soon as you take the mask off, wash your hands again. Anything you do or in your environment is common sense to just wash your hands. Use your ABC song, count to 20. Whatever it is you do that gets you that full 20 seconds of good, thorough hand washing is really important, or an alcohol-based gel. Remember, folks, we're in this together. This is a real virus, but we can really minimize the amount of exposure that we get, the amount of spread that we get, by using common practices and simple techniques like you've learned today.
And another thing to remember is a lot of these masks will contain some metal in them, and that metal isn't compatible with being used in the microwave, so please don't microwave them. They will burn. If they have elastic in them, the microwave destroys the elastic, so it doesn't hold also. So again, most important thing, hand washing, hand washing, hand washing, and be safe.